I'm live. It's Monday, and you know how I love Mondays. But before we get started, can we just say, welcome, co-host husband. You're all the way in LA doing some amazing things. And we're going to hear some stuff about that later.
Yes, definitely. You know, I can't leave out anybody. I can't leave out my peeps, you know.
Who's
everybody
your
wants to know. Everybody watching. Listen, yeah, you know, we have so many people watching at home sometimes. I go somewhere like, yo, you're the wife from the time. I'm like, yes. Come on, I'm good. But yeah, man, I have something lined up later.
Okay, well, that's good. I'm glad. I can't wait to hear.
Don't get jealous, though.
I'm always jealous. You know that. Before we get going, guys, we have a lovely co-host with us today. It's Emma. Welcome, Emma. How are you doing?
I'm great. Thank you. Happy to be here.
I'm happy to have you here.
I'm very happy to
now,
have you here.
I know Joel has been looking at Emma kind of side-eye all morning because he has a little crush. So we may have to have some conversations.
About, tell
but it's true. So we may need to go into counseling, you know.
All right, we might have to.
I'm just saying. We'll Emma.
I don't know. We could make this relationship work.
Emma, I'm not
We've spoken about it several times.
I know, right? But thank you for coming.
Yes.
We talk lots and lots and lots and lots. Yes, so Joel,
there's
what's
so much
trending today?
You know, I mean, the only thing that's been trending all week is the flood.
The rain.
Whenever it rains, it pours in Jamaica. And I'm telling you, because there's just, it's not even something, to some extent, it's unbelievable. The level at which the water can go, the level of damage that can be caused by it and all of that. But yeah. I think because it's happening time after time,
we
need to take a stand. Look at, we have a little representation there on the screen.
Yeah.
That's some serious levels.
Serious problems.
And, you know, a lot of people are left homeless. I don't know how soon they're going to get back to go on their, you know, get back on their feet and
but
get their homes together.
But you know what, though? I saw something in the newspaper that Andrew Holness says that he is going to financially assist those people that are severely impeded by the whole thing.
I mean, they have to.
But what I want
that's
to know
awesome.
Is, what does that mean? Like, what do you need before you get some assistance? You know what I'm saying?
Well, first of all, before we even go there, because Emma and I, we were talking this morning about the nationwide flooding aspect.
Yes, you were. You and Emma.
And don't, you see,
we're
talking about something serious, you know.
I just said, go ahead.
And I think in terms of nationwide flooding, it's not something like, okay, a certain section get some heavy rains.
Yeah.
Everybody was affected by it.
Time.
And I just feel you mentioned that we're getting some aid and whatever. Speaking of Andrew Holness as well, I want to tie in the fact that he had cut his trip to Dominican Republic short to come back to Jamaica.
Because we need him. We need our head, you know, ready to support us and assist us.
But it's good. Some people are looking at it and they're saying, why is this PR stunt again? Everybody just keeps...
Is it relevant? Well, I think that because what happened with the flooding, I know some people are downplaying it. But I think it was kind of a crisis. Like a lot of people couldn't get to work.
Some were severely affected.
Severely affected.
And when you talk about persons who would be in need of financial aid, I think the persons who would qualify for that would be persons who had their homes flooded out, their beds, you know, where it would fundamentally affect their basic living.
It's true. Yes. But what I'm saying with that is, that affected a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Affected.
So how is he going to decide which ones to give aid to is the point.
I leave it up to them. They have their tactics and technique. I just feel if you're out there, you're able to assist somebody. Don't wait on the government. That's a problem that we're having.
True.
Everybody feel like government, we need to wait on government for everything. If you have a little movement in place where you can go out and get some donations done, then I think you should take it up and do that. But I mean,
I think that's great, Joe.
It's bad. So how you coped with it, Emma?
Yeah. Actually, I was blessed enough not to be affected. I saw where other persons were, and we tried to, you know, be compassionate where time allowed the time for them to deal with
to start it out. But I mean I just hope everybody, you know, start to get back on their feet and think and get the help that we need. But
can we say
we're not going to talk about your
my favorite conversation though Donald Trump. Have you heard the latest?
Yes.
Have you heard the latest?
So they are, you know, the former Mexico president, he was hell-bent on, no, we're not paying for that wall. And
you
he used a special
Mexico
word.
That,
he always has a special word if you follow up with it.
Yeah.
And what's happening there, yeah, man, a very special word. What's happening there is that a joke is now going around where they would pay for the impeachment, but they'll not pay for the wall. Because, you know, Trump is on the brink of getting impeached now, according to some people. He's doing so many things. They felt that he should have been impeached from, February.
Right.
But
so the funny thing about it, though, is that, like you said, Mexico has said, no money. We don't have any money to contribute to this. when impeachment is mentioned, they're like, we'll pay. You know? So I think that's it.
What's the whole madness?
A funny thing is I saw something on social media where it had four pictures saying, have you ever looked at something and wondered how did it get there?
Yes.
One was, you know, a car crashing in a boat, stuck midway into the boat, another with a horse stuck in a fence, and then there's a picture of Donald Trump. It's like,
I just see people still haven't gotten over this win.
Surprise.
How did
he
get there?
Yes. And I think Mexico, I really believe that they would actually pay for the impeachment.
I think they will. I think they should. Possible. I'm only joking. Nobody says. But have you heard about BlackBerry? Guys,
yeah. What's that?
BlackBerry is making a comeback. How do we feel about that?
I don't know, you know.
Want your BlackBerry. Get rid of the iPhone. Like, get your BlackBerry
I was just
back,
gonna
right?
say the iPhone people are really the ones who are gonna be like,
I don't think the iPhone people are going to care, to be honest.
Both Android and Apple users will be like, where are you going with that?
Where are you going with that? But yo.
Yeah. What was the last BlackBerry? Was it a Storm?
It had buttons still.
Or, stop it. You guys are
or
lying.
Or Torch. I mean, I had a Pearl. You know. Trust me. What is that? Z10?
Z10. I don't know.
Z10. That's a big
one.
And it had a combination.
Oh, it was awful.
Well, you guys are forgetting the days. You see, I want to stay bad though. You guys are forgetting when BlackBerry was all that we had on BlackBerry Chat, and that was how
we couldn't survive outside of BlackBerry Chat
with everybody. Do you guys remember that BlackBerry Chat? Don't forget your roots, you know.
But we still have remnants.
Don't forget where we've been coming from.
We still have BlackBerry Curve. You look like you remember the curve.
I had one and a little volleyball in the middle.
What you had, Emma? You had one, Emma? Oh, Emma, you've been away ahead of your time.
Yeah, that.
We have to remember that the iPhones weren't so cute either, so we have to remember that.
There was a
grand move from the, a big ugly iPhone to this
about
one.
Phones.
Yes.
Did you hear about that text message lawsuit, the guy and the... Did you tell us about it, Joel? Tell us about it. I know you were laughing about it this morning.
No, because I know you're normally very... Why did he even sue her? So Emma, right? This guy took a woman out for the movies.
On a date?
On a date.
Right.
And she was texting. And he decided to sue her for $17 something cents. And he actually got the money.
$17 something.
So that's weird news.
But his reason for suing her was he's like, I am on a date with you. And you're sending a text message to somebody else. Mm-hmm. I am upset.
So it's real.
Lawsuit filed.
So hold on. Was there a contract?
Was there a...
I just feel it's just real antisocial behavior.
He's paying for her time
in the most legitimate.
You know what, though? I just want to say that for me, this is a little bit crazy. But you know what? Follow us at TVJ_daytime live. Guys, to join in the conversation, is getting hotter and hotter. We have so much to talk about.
Yes, what do
and
have
let's not
up?
Forget, it's Man Crush Mondays. Yes. I'm happy.
Listen.
Yes.
You move from yourself, you move to somebody else, you move all
It doesn't
the
matter.
Place.
I'm just like, men, hallelujah. You're watching Daytime Live, and we'll be right back. Join us after the break. I love it. You know how I love